So Josh.
Eric, yes.
What are we talking about today?
I think we're talking about that Mango D.
Mango Dodger. I love it. I love it.
We've made this 4 years? 4 years, sound right? 5 years?
Oh, it's probably been five, I think.
Yeah. This was probably one of the first barrel-aged projects I worked on, naturally, working on a barrel-aged double IPA, as you do.
As you do. As you are wont to do.
Yeah. When I first started, we'd been barrel-aging kind of like everything, like as we took the opportunity, we get some barrels in, we had some beer in the tank.
So fun.
And there was some Mango Dodger in. We tried our hand at aging a few different IPAs, double IPAs, before they were dry hopped.
Mm-hmm.
Just because that malt bill of a double IPA tends to be bigger, chewier, sort of like a pale version of a stout in some ways, you mm-hmm. know, no roast character or chocolate malt or that kind of thing, but still very big and full-bodied.
So a big roasty double IPA.
Right.
Chocolatey IPA. Big,
that's, we're going to hit like 100 beers, so, we'll
probably,
you know.
Yeah, one of them.
At some point, I got to make that roasty chocolatey double IPA, just like everybody's been craving. We had some Rock Dodger in some rye barrels. So in barrels, you get micro oxygenation, so small amounts of oxidation, and it's not as aggressive. It doesn't treat the beer quite as badly. So a lot of the sweeter, caramely flavors you get out of barrel-aged beers is at least in part a result of the oxygen that comes in slowly through the wood over time. And in this particular beer, it created this kind of like caramel mango mm-hmm. flavor. The next year we added mangoes into the barrel. It came out really nice. The year after that, I got crazy and asked for permission to put it in barrels after we dry hopped it. So like the concept of putting hops in barrels, I don't think anybody's doing
You're
that.
You're a madman.
Well, it's just, it's like pretty high up on the list of like, why would you ruin your beer?
So,
I just kept thinking, well, oxidation or like long-term aging, long-term being like a month and a half or 2 months. This beer is like a full double dry hopped IPA when it goes on top of mangoes in rye barrels for about 2 months. We don't want to go too long. If we go too long, it's going to fall off. But the result, we get it out, we dry hop it a third time just to brighten the hops because obviously they've sort of fallen off in aroma over the time in barrels. But all of that together, brings forward the richness of like a mango syrup kind of character,
right.
Some caramel character. I think of this beer kind of as a cross between an IPA and a pineapple upside down cake. If you think like that caramel and that rich, syrupy like tropical fruit, and then you get a nice little rye spice and wood on the back end,
for
just
sure.
enough, just a kiss. Like I said, it's only in the barrel for 2 months, so some of the balance is trying to find rye barrels that will give us good flavor in a short period of time. And that's hit and miss every year. I think every year this beer is a little bit different. So if you're somebody who's like, Mango Dodger always tastes different. You're right. Like, it's just a function of what barrels we can source, how good they are, like how good are the mangoes this year? You know, we've had mangoes that have been a little flatter in flavor. We had mangoes that have been really bright. But I think the beer is always good this year. Oh, you tell me what you think about the beer this year.
This year, I'm getting definitely more mango than previous years. It's not necessarily, you know, a cloying, sweetness. There is a little bit more residual, you know, sweetness or sugars in it. It feels that way anyway. The rye is a little bit more subdued than years past, but still there. All the pieces are definitely there, and I think this is actually, realistically, I think if you've liked this in the past or you tried it and you're like, yeah, it's kind of okay, but it's a little bit too much for me, try it again this year because I think this is going to appeal to an even wider audience. But I think fans of our traditional Mango Dodger are going to really like this too. This one, it blows me away how good a barrel-aged IPA can be. It's just not something that you...
This is a brewery favorite every year. I think we have... This is one of the beers that the highest number of staff get excited about and ask, like, when's it coming? Is it going to be ready? And we get excited when we put the mangoes in the barrels and rack it because we know it's like 2.5 months away from being able to drink it.
It's like when we get excited for a Pilsner.
Yeah, exactly. That's next week, over the Ivies next week, which is the probably, if you want to drink like the brew team here, drink the Over the Ivy when it comes out next week.
Yep.
But But yeah, this is I think this is a fan favorite. This is a staff favorite. It's awesome every year. This year, it's extra fruity, a little less rye, but extra fruity, and still very clearly Mango Dodger. So this is one of our weirder ones. If you avoid it because you're like, how can a barrel-aged IPA be good?
You're wrong.
Like I understand where you're coming from, because it was sort of one of those projects that was like, this will never turn into anything, but
it did.
It's tasty. It's real good. Good beer.
Yeah. If you don't want to try, I mean, four packs are on the show. Will be on the shelf starting next week across the great state of Iowa. And then if you want to just try a little bit, come down to the tap room. It's supposed to start getting nicer weather, and you can come up and just ask for a little taste or whatever if you're worried about it. But yeah, it's definitely something that if it scares you, give it a try.
And if you come down to the tap room this weekend, check out the new Beer a Week graphic. We've had one the last 2 years. It's been, what did I say earlier, like about 114 straight weeks with at least one release.
Yeah.
Yeah. So going steady, going strong, continuing this year. And we've got like the new, I think this is the coolest looking.
Yeah.
It's going to feature all the beautiful art that various local artists and 818, our design studio that works with us, have all done for us.
Yeah.
Kind of show off the cool art on all the cans. This is the Mango Dodger one, of course, and it'll be going up there. But each week as we add beers, we'll add new panels to the wall, and kind of hopefully by the end of the year we'll have produced a
nice mosaic.
Cool mosaic.
Yeah.
Yeah. So make sure to like, subscribe, share, binge our YouTube videos.
Binge them.
YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like you said, sign up for our newsletter too that comes out. We send that out.
Yeah.
It's a lot of fun.
Let you know all the releases coming out.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of them.
There's a lot.
Only one release this week, but we got eight in the next 2 weeks, before next week and for the week after. So we're just taking like a little bit of a breather this week with one.
Yeah, I love it. Yeah, thanks for watching our videos. Thanks for supporting us. And keep drinking good beer. Tell your friends to drink good beer.
Cheers, guys.
Cheers.